Now, the debate over keeping whales in captivity has been in the forefront since the release of the documentary Blackfish.
UT reporter Monica Garcia was at Point Loma High School on Monday, where students got a chance to ask the director some questions.
Please give her a round of applause.
Budding filmmakers from Point Loma High School got a special visit from the director of the documentary Blackfish. The film sheds light on the problems surrounding SeaWorld and the poor treatment of captive whales. We talked to the award-winning director Gabriella Cowperthwaite, who says when she first started the film, she wasn't an activist, just a filmmaker asking questions.
I became interested in doing this project because I couldn't understand why Don Branchot, a top-level trainer at SeaWorld, came to be killed by a killer whale in 2010.
Cowperthwaite was invited down from Los Angeles to meet students who created a response video to her documentary calling on SeaWorld to take action.
It's really incredible to know that kids are starting to look at these things differently, and they're not drinking what they're pouring, you know? And I think that's huge, and that's something to be said for all kids that have reacted to the film.
The director was also taking part in a Q&A panel organized by the school's cinematic arts program and a local group called Kids Eco Club, founded by 13-year-old Max Gwynn.
Well, I've been to SeaWorld many, many times, and after seeing the movie Blackfish, I was really, really shocked and sad at what the truth was. And on this argument, I really want to hear both sides, SeaWorld's side and Blackfish's side.
So it's inside this state-of-the-art studio at Point Loma High School where a handful of students are making their voices heard around the world.
Is it true the orcas in your exhibits were kidnapped from their families?
The PSA called Dear SeaWorld was filmed back in November and gained national attention for its hard-hitting questions. In the video, students vowed not to go back to the amusement park until whales and dolphins were retired from show business altogether.
I think the video has made a difference. Like, it's other people see the problem now, but I feel like SeaWorld doesn't do anything. Like, I feel like we still need to know why they're doing this.
Meanwhile, Cowperthwaite says it's ultimately up to parents to set an example.
Parents and kids have to make their own decision, look at both sides, think about whether or not anything that SeaWorld does is really worth sacrificing these animals. I mean, is it really Is that really what we want to teach our kids?
And students are already working on a second PSA, this time calling on SeaWorld to answer questions during a scheduled debate. Reporting from Point Loma High School, Monica Garcia, UT San Diego News.